like 45 minutes. I had went to Noodles and Company and shit. I ain't had Noodles and Company in like 4 years type shit. It's been like 2 years. So now my food's super warm. I'm finna spark up, smoke, and eat. And play Madden.
EA Sports. It's in the game.
To me, it's all about Tom Brady. He's just one of those guys that if the game is on the line, you need a big play, he'll make that play for you.
Say what? Talking with them nigga. This shit out the states. I live in Wisconsin, my nigga. That's that out the state, guys. Only smoke out of state, guys, nigga. My brother like big time in that shit. That's why it's out of state, my nigga. My brother really do this shit. Like if that nigga get caught, that nigga in jail for some minute, for a minute, that like they'll charge that nigga for kingpin, low key. And I ain't like bragging on the nigga, what I'm saying. I get the best of the best weed. This that weed you get shipped and you gotta send it to somebody else's address. You don't know nothing about that. Yeah, that shit, it's illegal as fuck here. See, here you smoking, you damn near getting a felony. Especially if you're around kids. They can't stop it though.
Welcome to the NFL.
You get caught with more than a gram on you, that's a felony.
Two teams will need their quarterbacks to step up and lead their offenses on the gridiron today.
No, let me get that wrong. If you get caught in more than 3-5, that's a felony.
Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey.
Nah, not where
this
I'm at.
The scene just before we came on air, this New York crowd fired up by the arrival of their G-men as they burst from the
Wisconsin
locker room.
Money.
They're ready to go as the Giants get set to match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Can't tell me about my state.
Fielded about a yard deep. And some space here.
That return gives them a golden opportunity to go out in front. How will the defense respond after giving up that type of a return?
Set up the screen to Fournette. There he goes inside the 30. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The Jags picking up the first down there, a gain of 12.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backside of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody coming. Oh, he just stuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box.
I don't mind being humble, but ready for the number. You've
got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
Again, it's Fournette, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're
bitch, you playing cover three, you a pussy.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and let other people
cover three
tackles.
That bitch ass nigga.
He can make a play himself, as we just saw there. That's a big day.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Bortles to throw on second down. Got his man. It's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Allen Robinson from 3 yards out, and the Jags have taken the early lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route ordinarily is probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Here's Lambeau out to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. Of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs, and let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
On second down, here's Manning. Flushed out right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Unique Ngakoue in there to get him for a loss of 5. Third and long for the Giants, and Eli following the sack. And now some motion before the snap. And this will be our first penalty of the night's proceedings. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. And they're going to go soft on the corners. On third and long, it's Manning. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Here's Brad Wing now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. And taken right at the 35. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Jaguars go on offense, first down and 10. As possession changes hands here, I get to talk to you about the Super Bowl. It's New England and Philly, a repeat of Super Bowl 39, although that one was in Jacksonville. This one, of course, in Minneapolis.
Yeah, I think the only thing that really changes is the weather. But this one's in a dome, so I don't think that that's a real issue for them at all. But guess what? New England has the same coach, and the same quarterback. That's a big advantage for the Patriots.
Meanwhile, for Philly, everything's new, including a quarterback in Nick Foles that they didn't think would be there right now.
And I'm not sure Nick Foles thought he would be there at that point. But remember, he's been to the Pro Bowl before, been to the playoffs as a starter in the NFL. He's got a chance to play a really big game.
On second down, here's Bortles. Oh, it's a screen pass. It's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. Bortles going to run the draw with Fournette. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Alongside the former defensive back Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Jaguar football as we begin quarter number two. They've got it second and four to start things out. They'll run it again with Fournette. They'll wind up getting four down to the 36.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, a guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Bortles to throw on third and one. And that's complete to Lewis. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A good pickup there, a 22.
There's so many things to watch for when you play defense and reading.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line.
For the New York Giants, as their offense comes back out there, yeah, last year, 3-13, and that was off from just a year of being a playoff team at 11-5. They were 31st in total points, 31st in overall defense, so a lot of changes need to take place.
They certainly do, and frankly, the 11-5 season masked the changes that are coming now because their numbers weren't that great in the 11-5 season. Somehow they found a way to win those key important games and accumulate a nice record. But you look at the underpinnings, and you'll see the cracks are already.
Pressure gets to him, and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line, Yannick Ngakoue in there to sack him for a loss of six. Third and long for the Giants, and Eli following the sack. Working from the gun, Manning. He finds Beckham complete. He's at the 50. The 30, past the 20, touchdown, Giants. Odell Beckham, 95 yards. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Well, they were back in the shadows of their own goalpost, and that flipped quickly.
So much for playing it safe. I mean, the conservative, easy call, run the football, take care of it, create some space, pump the ball away, but no, let's throw it. And sometimes a defense's aggressiveness is used against them because when you've got people backed up, your natural inclination is to try and really force them back, and sometimes they get burned that way.
And they got burned there. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they're through the interception and finish off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know what, a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A big run there, 29 yards and a first. They go play action here on first down. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On second down, here's Fournette. Fournette, first down, still going. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. A great play there. 35 yards. And the Jaguars have taken the lead. And he
He's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Lambeau out to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
To throw, it's Manning. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Shepard. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. So a minute 56 to play in this first half. We're back to East Rutherford, but first this timeout. Throwing on first down is Manning. Buying time to escape. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Calais Campbell able to get in there and drop him behind the line. Now Manning throwing on second down. Throw left side complete to Ingram. And shedding him off, now open field. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains.
We didn't need to ask around the league, but we got to confirm this guy's a good player. They've got to find a way to get him more involved, call a few more plays that target him.
Absolutely, because here we are toward the end of the first half, and that's the first target, not just the first catch, first target. Yeah, big hit there as he runs into a brick wall. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers?
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Yannick Ngakoue in there to get him for his second sack of the night. Manning the throw on second down. And this is Shepard on the catch. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Throwing is Manning. Eluding the pressure right. He may try and run for this. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. Now on 4th and inches, they're going to want to talk this over. We get a timeout. As they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on 4th and inches. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he takes it into the end zone for a giant TD. Orleans Darqua taking it in from a yard out. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And he's able to put it through. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get set to go again. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Yeah, that nigga be pressing niggas.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. Got some room at the 30. And he'll cut it out to the sideline. A big play there,
just before halftime. 48 yards.
And the crazy thing is, the nigga only like 5'3".
So all of a sudden, with that run, maybe now a chance for points here.
It's a total mind shift, isn't it? Because what you were saying before was, hey, let's just get out of here, get the half over with. Instead, we can get some points now.
They keep it with Fournette on first down. Finding room to the 20. Touchdown, Jaguars. A great effort there in the final seconds of the first half. And the Jaguars have moved out in front. So they're able to break the tie just before halftime. Now they just don't want anything crazy to happen on the ensuing kickoff.
Yeah, they want to just add the extra point, get the kickoff taken care of, and get to the locker room with the lead that they fought so hard to get.
Here's
that little nigga, real life 5'3" pressing niggas. That's funny.
Fielded about a yard deep. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. The New York set to take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
One final try now for Manning. He's going to look deep down the field. And it's knocked away and incomplete. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is fielded a couple yards deep. This return nets positive as he gets past the 20.
Oh, Dale got a fumble that. Come on, bro.
And the Giants ready to come out now. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Eli, not something you see a lot, sporting the wheels and picking up the first.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Manning gonna throw. And the Jags get to him as down he goes.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. Five sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire.
But when this ball's tipped and intercepted, picked off around the 27. Room here to run. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Ah, yes, the old tip drill works to perfection there.
Ah, you're bringing back great memories. Used to love that drill. And a lot of times in practice, you work on it, not just one tip, but multiple tips, just in case the ball stays in the air for a while, to have an awareness and the ability to go up and grab it, and then you want to get some blocking support and end up in the opposite end zone.
In that tip drill, what do you yell?
For us, it was Oski, okay? Oski
was an interception. Different teams.
Different teams have different ways of doing it. I've heard bingo, jackpot. The worst I ever heard, though, was Frankenstein. You don't want it to be a
three-syllable
word.
Yeah.
You want to get it right down and go. Oski is really the preferred word.
Oski. Manning now on first down. And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Throwing now is Manning. Open man right side is Ingram. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off at the 39. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dump.
Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. And he cuts it back right, and he's got touchdown, Jaguar.